Dear Mr. President, it is with considerable regret that I find myself communicating on record to a public official with whom I once had so much hope for integrity in office. I have personally written letters to you by registered mail and through Joshua Dubois on June 14, 2010, July 9, and July 30th of 2010. None of my letters advising you of the corruption and bribery of senior public officials, past and present, have been accorded the respect of a reply or action. Numerous other parties have also addressed with you, in writing, details of transgressions and RICO-level actions involving elected officials and bankers. None have been given the courtesy of a response for very serious charges. Ignoring them has simply incited parties to address a collective marshaled campaign. You have also been advised, previously, by my letters, of the corruption dealing with Mr. Falcone settlement monies and others. Enclosed is a letter describing future corruption by senior officials tampering with bank records. Theft, fraud, bribery, and conspiracy. This attached corruption report by Mr. Falcone is currently being shared with certain congressional members, and these members are seeking to have a congressional panel set up to investigate corruption by government officials that you have allowed to take place in your administration. Mr. President, as you are aware, if you are allowing these types of corruption in your administration, and if you're not taking action, these are grounds for impeachment. I pray for you to make the right decision. Sincerely, Walter E. Fauntroy, Member of Congress, 1971 to 1991. Mr. Falcone reports that in early September, former President George Bush Sr. orchestrated a government plane equipped with six of his key people to go to Germany, the Caribbean, Spain, and on to Hong Kong. They traveled from Hong Kong back to the U.S. approximately October 26th. During this government-paid and sponsored trip, they modified and changed records and bank books of George Bush Sr. in Germany and the Caribbean for his payoffs he's received by utilizing Falcone's money over the years. These allegations have been reported to the FBI and other agencies by Mr. Falcone over 2 years ago, and to this date, there's been no action taken. Over a year and a half ago, Joe Biden began looking into helping Mr. Falcone in getting his settlement funds released. Then he was approached by Hillary Clinton to discontinue his support and to help block the release of Mr. Falcone's settlement funds. Vice President Joe Biden agreed in lieu of a large payoff of over $200 million he's received over the last year and a half. Subsequently, Joe Biden became aware that Mr. Falcone had become knowledgeable of his payments held in a German bank. Therefore, under the direction of George Bush Sr., the traveling team modified the records of Joe Biden's German account. They sent out approximately $200 million out of the German bank to a bank in Spain and Hong Kong. At this time, all particulars, including account information, will be shared with the congressional members. These banks and accounts will be constantly monitored until this is dealt with in congressional hearings. Mr. Falcone reported earlier that former President George Bush Sr. orchestrated several government-sponsored planes equipped with key people to modify and change various bank accounts and records in various countries. Commerce Bank in Frankfurt, Germany is one bank in particular where they modified incoming and outgoing money wires of various account holders on Bush Sr.'s orders. The funds in question in named accounts were derived from an offspring of stolen funds of Mr. Falcone's and are separate and apart from Mr. Falcone's other government settlement fund account. George Bush Sr., in partnership with Michael Herzog and his partner Paul Gwinnett, gave clearance to Herzog to steal Mr. Falcone's original principal, the funds to syndicate, and set up a separate trading fund fronted by Mitt Romney. The profits from trading activities were used for themselves without Mr. Falcone's approval or participation. At one point, Herzog wanted to return Mr. Falcone's funds, and Bush Sr. said no. Herzog advanced the proceeds from trading utilizing Mr. Falcone's stolen funds to accounts of George Bush Sr.'s George W. Bush, Mitt Romney, and others. Mitt Romney has received over $1 billion from Mr. Falcone's stolen funds. Mr. Falcone has filed complaints with the FBI, Homeland Security, and the Federal Reserve regarding his stolen funds and the corruption involved. The files are still open and have never been addressed, resolved, or settled. To date, President Obama, with full knowledge of Mr. Falcone's stolen funds and the corruption involving his administration, has not taken any action whatsoever. Dennis Blair, White House former member of the President's Security Council, was very aware of the facts and corruption involving Mr. Falcone's settlement funds. Mr. Blair went to President Obama and Rahm Emanuel and told them they needed to satisfy and clear the Falcone matter. Blair and Rahm Emanuel had a major run-in because it was discovered that Rahm had also received proceeds from Mr. Falcone's stolen funds. One of the reasons Dennis Blair stepped down was he felt there was too much corruption in Obama's administration and he couldn't take it any longer. After Blair stepped down, Obama later said Blair didn't step down, he fired him in an effort to cover the truth. When Obama took over as president, Mr. Falcone and other government settlements were about to be settled. Instead of concluding the settlements, Obama's administration, with full knowledge of Obama, took advantage of the main player, Bush Sr., and stole money from the settlement fund for personal use. The money that Geithner stole is small in comparison to Romney's stolen billion. George Bush Sr. will do everything to cover up not only his tracks and his role in the stolen Falcone funds, he also wants to cover up the fact that Mitt Romney is involved in fronting for known criminals like Michael Herzog and his partner, Paul Gwinnett. Romney and Bush Sr. are extremely close. Bush Sr. is trying to clear the road so that Romney can become the next presidential candidate. Because Mitt Romney couldn't clear the scrutiny of his financial records and the source of over $1 billion deposited in his offshore bank account, he was not vetted as a vice presidential candidate for John McCain. Romney has not declared these funds, nor has he paid any personal taxes on them. If Romney is really considering running for president in the future, there will be no way he's going to pass clearance. No matter how many records George Bush Sr. and others may change, information regarding his stolen Falcone funds will be splashed all over the world.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.